Hi, art friends, and if you're like me and you've been enjoying this beautiful weather and going outside and exploring nature, then you are going to love this art lesson. It is how to make your own land art, and it's super fun and easy. So before we get started, we want to understand what land art is. Well, it's also known as earth art, environmental art, and earthworks. This is an art movement that emerged in the 1960s and 70s, and it's basically art that's made directly in the landscape, sculpting the land itself. The artists use natural materials like earth, rocks, sticks, flowers to make their sculptures, and it began in the United States and Great Britain. The element of art that we really want to focus on is texture. In art, texture can be real or implied. So real texture is what we're going to be using because we're going to be using real objects from nature. Let's take a look at some artists who are famous for their land art. The first one, his name is Robert Smithson, and his most famous land art sculpture is called the Spiral Jetty. And wow, look at that amazing sculpture. The other artist is Andy Goldsworthy. He is a British sculptor, photographer, and artist who is also an environmentalist, and he lives and works in Scotland. Love this quote by Robert Smithson: "Nature does not proceed in a straight line. Rather, it is a sprawling development." So we're not going to be using a lot of straight lines in this artwork. You want to look for a variety of textures in our objects. So we might want to use some things that feel smooth, maybe rough and bumpy, or soft. So are you ready to try it? This is the most fun part. We're going to get ready to gather up our supplies and make some amazing earth art. So first you're going to need a container to put your materials in. So a Ziploc bag, a bowl, a paper plate, or all three work really great. Then we're going to go outside. So I always go on a dog walk every single day with my doggie, and that's when I really like to look for and collect different objects. So you can think of it as a nature treasure hunt. All you have to do when you find a really interesting natural object is pick it up, put it in your bag, and then keep looking. Once you have a variety of different objects and textures, then you need to find a nice and shady and comfortable spot to start assembling and making your design. So I found this nice little shady spot in my backyard, and I'm using the stepping stone as my canvas to start arranging my objects and creating my design. So I began by placing this amazing starfish in the center of my stepping stone. Then I had a really beautiful hibiscus flower, and I put the petals around it to create a radial pattern. Radial means circle, so using a circle in your design can really help you find a spot to start. A very popular radial design is called a mandala. So if you arrange your objects in a circle and create patterns, you're kind of making like a natural mandala. And if you don't want to use a circle design, you probably want to try to make sure that your design is balanced. Or if you're making something funny like a face or an animal or a cool shape out of your natural objects, you just want to make sure that both sides are balanced and that your design looks interesting. Once you have finished arranging your objects and you like the way it looks, then of course you want to take a really good picture of your design. A lot of land art is temporary, which means that it's not going to stay there forever. It's going to either wash away or get blown away. So taking a picture is an important step of preserving your artwork. So here is my finished design. I love how it turned out. I took a great picture of it, but I can't wait to try some more. Definitely like the spiral. So I'll be heading to the beach, and I hope you guys enjoyed this lesson. Bye!